Do you know that trans fats increase the production of lower density lipoproteins? What is this relevant to your metabolic health? What is happening with this trans fat, and why have we listened too much about that they are toxic to our metabolism? Research evidence has shown that trans fats contribute to the formation of plaque in arteries, lowering the production of the ApoB lipoproteins, altering the metabolism of cholesterol, and increasing the predisposition for heart attacks, as well as some types of cancers. Start reducing the consumption of these trans fats just by reading the labels that you consume in your food, because many of these products that are advertised as light, healthy, or low fat have these trans fats, or they are also known as hydrogenated fats. So all of those two names is just the same, but be careful with the information, because many times we just go by the big label, big advertisement, and we find out later that that healthy option was more toxic. What is happening with these metabolisms of your fats? The lipoproteins and all of the metabolism of fats are designed to transport these kind of fats into a capsule of triglycerides and cholesterol. Each of these lipoproteins have these apoproteins in the surface, and they function as the GPS to direct them to where they have to go, to where they have to transport these kind of fats. So what the research has shown is that these lipoproteins containing the ApoB are synthesized in the liver. ApoB100 are very low density lipoproteins, or in the intestine we have ApoB48 kilomicrons. The kilomicron is a smaller particle that transports a lot of fats to their destination. These particles are released into the circulation, where they can undergo a hydrolysis process. What is this? They are breaking down into small pieces so that we can digest them, and we can turn them into energy by the mechanism known as lipolysis. And this is performed because we have an enzyme that is helping us to degrade these kind of fats, which is called lipase. So all of our organs, all of the signals are synchronized so that you detect what kind of fats you are consuming, and so that you turn on your engines to start producing energy once you get rid of the carbohydrates, because that's the sequence. So if we are contributing with these kinds of trans fats, what happens is that these ApoB100 are the ones that are going to stick to these low density lipoproteins, which are the LDL, that they came out, or they come out when you have an analysis of your lipid profile. And once you see that you have a higher quantity of these LDLs, this is a major risk to develop atherosclerosis and problems in your heart. Why? Because you are narrowing the diameter of your arteries to pump the blood, and also you are not allowing the proper detoxification of your system. This is what is happening. That's why binding of this ApoB100 LDL to adipocytes via these LDLs inhibits the intracellular mechanism of noradrenaline-induced lipolysis in adipocytes. What does it mean? This means that if you are producing an interference of the signals due to this ApoB100, your body is not going to detect the signal of noradrenaline and is not going to send the fats to be breaking down, and you won't obtain enough energy. But moreover, you are going to have deposits in your arteries. You are going to create these remnants in the walls of your arteries, and that will complicate after. So that will lead to hypertension. That will lead, of course, to a problem that can be a heart attack, and that can also lead to resistance of these signaling pathways also in terms of glucose and insulin, which is going to lead as a sequence as the metabolic syndrome. So if you see, every nutrient and everything that we are consuming is triggering your system, either in a positive way or in a negative way. Of course, if we consume more toxic food and more food that is processed, that is going to contribute to raise the level or to rise the level of these kind of fats. So be careful with the type of fats that you are consuming. Consuming any other type of fat, saturated, unsaturated, of course, and polyunsaturated, those are the best choices. And also not abusing the saturated fats coming from animal sources. So just be careful about these trans fats, any kind of processed food, any kind of food that has more than three names that you cannot understand because they are chemical names, because they are artificial things, has these kind of fats, in spite of not advertising that in the label. So just be careful with the kind of food and avoid this by reducing the amount, increasing exercise, and increasing sleep. Be careful with the sleep, because during the time of sleep, you are also detoxifying your body for these kind of toxic fats. That's the purpose of today's video, to just give you a hint and some tips so that you can detect the kind of food that can drain your energy, that can disrupt your system in terms of the processing of the fats, and also lead you to the development of metabolic syndrome or to the development of any cardiovascular event. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the information, if it resonates with you, if you think it can help someone else, please help me to share it. Thank you for connecting, Dan. It's a pleasure to see you here, and have a wonderful afternoon and rest of the week. Thank you. Bye.